Hello, my name is Dr. Girish Nelivigi. I am a urologist with 20 years of post-qualification experience. There are, broadly speaking, there are two ways to treat an enlarged prostate. One is by medical management, second is by surgical management. Medical management consists of tablets which have to be taken on a long-term basis. These tablets are of various categories. Some tablets, they change the hormone status of the body to decrease the size of the prostate, whereas the other category of drugs, they decrease the pressure within the prostate so that there is ease of passage of urine. But these drugs have to be taken on a lifelong basis, like the way we take for diabetes and hypertension. Because as we discussed earlier, prostate enlargement is a lifelong process. Once you stop these drugs, the person will get back the symptoms he had before he started the drugs. The second category of treatment is by surgery. Now, in surgery, there are various types of surgeries. Previously, there used to be open prostatectomy, where a cut was made on the skin and the prostate was removed. But that is a historical surgery and is no more practiced. The most commonly done surgery for prostate enlargement is a surgery called TURP, or transurethral resection of the prostate. This is an endoscopic surgery where an endoscope is passed through the urinary passage or through the penis, and under vision, the prostate is cut in pieces and these pieces are removed through the endoscope itself. The energy that is used to cut the prostate is an electrical energy. The second category of treatment under the heading of surgery is by laser prostatectomy. A laser prostatectomy, as the name itself signifies, is again an endoscopic surgery wherein the energy that is used to remove the cut the prostate and ablate the prostate is laser. However, broadly speaking, both TURP and laser prostatectomy are done in the same way. Both are done endoscopically. In both, an endoscope is passed through the urethra and the prostate after cutting is removed through the endoscope. In laser prostatectomy, there are various subcategories because various lasers are used in the treatment of prostate. The commonest laser that is used in the treatment of prostate is a holmium laser. We have diode laser also. Then there is a green light laser. However, holmium prostatectomy is the commonest prostatectomy that is done under the laser prostatectomy category. Prostate surgery, whether you do by TURP or laser prostatectomy, usually takes about 1 hour on an average. In case of small prostate, it may take 30 minutes, whereas in case of large prostate, it may take as much as 1.5 hours. So you can take a range of 30 minutes to 1.5 hours for prostate surgery. Prostate surgeries are typically done under spinal anesthesia, where an injection is given in the back and only the part of the body below the umbilicus is anesthetized. The patient is fully conscious during surgery, and almost immediately after surgery, he can have something to drink and then something to eat. The duration of hospitalization after surgery is about 2 or maximum 3 days. After surgery, the patient will have a catheter or a tube in his urinary bladder so that all the blood and the urine is drained into the urine bag. So this tube is kept for a duration of 1 to 3 days. In case of laser prostatectomy, many urologists remove it within a day. Whereas in conventional prostatectomy, that is TURP, it is kept for 2 to 3 days. And the duration of hospitalization is, as I told you, 2 to 3 days after prostate surgery. after the patient goes home, he can get back to his normal activities like walking, going to the bathroom, climbing up and down the stairs, etc. To resume going back to his duties, it may take as much as a week. And in case of heavy duty, like people who do manual labor, etc., it may take about 10 days. Whereas a person who does sedentary duties, like an IT professional or a person who has got desktop jobs, he can go back to his work within about 4 to 5 days after prostatectomy. There is no difference in post-surgery pain between laser prostatectomy and TURP. The only difference is the duration of indwelling catheter. In laser prostatectomy, the catheter is kept for 1 day, whereas in conventional TURPs, it is kept for 2 days. So whatever pain is because of the catheter, that is shorter in case of laser prostatectomy. The healing is by a natural process. After surgery, the doctor tells the patient to actually start walking on post-operative day one itself. If the patient has constipation, that is treated, because whenever a patient strains to pass stools, that causes more pain and that causes some bleeding. So we have to guard against constipation, and if the patient has got chronic constipation, he should inform the doctor so that the doctor starts laxatives immediately after surgery. The second precaution or the second thing that the patient should do is to consume a lot of water or any other fluid after surgery so that the urine output is high and the urine becomes clear as soon as possible. Other than these, there are no special precautions that the patient has to take after prostate surgery.